Welcome to the new episode of Statistical Computing. In this session, I am going to discuss about standard deviation, variance, and their relative measures. Let's see about standard deviation. Standard deviation is a statistical measure that dispersion of a data set relative to its mean. It tells you how much your data is spread out around the mean or average. For example, which subject scores are close to the average score and which are away from its average score, as well as it tells you their ratio percentage. It is calculated as the square root of variance. The standard deviation is calculated as the square root of variance by its determining each data point's deviation relative to their mean. If data points are further from mean, there is a higher deviation within the data set. Thus, the more spread out the data, the higher standard deviation, and less spread out the data, the lower standard deviation. So the higher standard deviation and the lower standard deviation you can find in the figure. In the figure you can find a central black thick line that shows the average, the mean line. So the blue portion area shows those parts are nearer to closer to the central part, I mean the mean or the average, and the brown portion and the green portions are away from the average line. So in that case, there is three parts of standard deviation: standard deviation part 1, part 2, and part 3. So in that figure you can find the difference between the small standard deviation and the large standard deviation. In the large standard deviation, the curve of the graph is spread right to their mean, right? And in the small standard deviation, in compared to the large standard deviation, it's less spreaded value, right? So the curve is like the tall curve. Let's see the formula of standard deviation. There are a set of formulas. So in this slide I have discussed two set of formulas for the standard deviation. If the variable x takes n values, x1, x2, up to xn, and if x bar will be the arithmetic mean of these values, then the formula in the case of simple series, a standard deviation equals to under root of sigma x minus x bar whole square divided by small n, where x bar is equals to sigma x divided by small n. Why there is a small n? Because it's a case of simple series, so you do not have any frequencies, so there you have to count the number of observations in the series. So it is a small n. In the case of frequency distribution, so the difference is standard deviation is equals to square root of sigma f into x minus x bar whole square divided by capital N, where capital N is equals to sigma f, which is total of your frequency, and here x bar is sigma fx divided by capital N. Let's see the another set of a standard deviation formula. In case of simple series, a standard deviation is equals to under root of sigma x square divided by small n minus x bar whole square. So here the x bar whole square is sigma x divided by small n. So this individual term whole square, right? So instead of x bar square, you can write sigma x divided by n whole square as well for this formula. So this formula can be written in that way also. And in case of frequency distribution, the standard deviation is equals to sigma x square divided by capital N minus x bar whole square. Remember, in this formula, it's clearly mentioned it is sigma f into x square, right? Okay. So that part I'll also explain at the time of the calculation of the standard deviation as well. Let's see the alternative methods to find the standard deviation. So in this slide I have discussed the direct method, assume mean or the shortcut method, and the step deviation method. The direct method usually used for small type of questions where you have a direct values of, let's say, the x bar or sigma x or n is given in the question, so you can find the standard deviation. How to find the standard deviation using direct method, that I will discuss in the next video, and their calculation as well. Let's see the assume mean method formula, or we can say the shortcut method to find the standard deviation. So the formula is standard deviation is equals to sigma d square divided by small n minus sigma d divided by n whole square. So here d is equals to x minus a. A is assume mean, and the formula of step deviation method. So only the one change in the formula. So instead of d, we have here d dash. So the d dash is x minus capital A divide by h, where h is the highest common factor, and at the end you have to multiply the whole formula with that highest common factor, which is h. In case of frequency distribution, so frequency distribution, both the group and the ungroup frequency distribution, so we have the frequencies. So we have to multiply our d with f. So here the term becomes sigma f into d square, right? Or the sigma f into d. So if it is the step deviation, so it becomes sigma f into d dash whole square, or maybe the sigma f to d dash square, right? So remember the different part in this formula is it's a sigma f into d square. So you have to multiply f into d square, right? So that means it's a f into d, right? It's a 2d in that formula. So it is not like sigma f d square, so f into d and then square. It's not a whole square, right? It's a f into d, right? So you have to remember this term. So this step also I will mention in my next video, how to calculate the standard deviation using this formulas. So that's the difference. Let's see the advantages and the disadvantages of the standard deviation. So the merits are, the standard deviation is rigidly defined measure and its value is always fixed. It is based on all the item in the series, so it is best measure of dispersion among the category. It's a least affected by the sampling fluctuation than other measures such as mean deviation and quartile deviation. Standard deviation can be used for further mathematical treatment. Let's see the demerits of the standard deviation. It's difficult to compute and understand as compared to other measures of dispersion. So the mean deviation and quartile deviations are much more easy to understand and to calculate than the standard deviation. Standard deviation is highly affected by the extreme values in the series, right? So it's give more focus to the extreme values, the lower and the higher values. The standard deviation cannot be obtained for open and class frequency distribution. Let's see the variance. It's also another type of the dispersion, the absolute dispersion. The square root of standard deviation is called the variance. On other hand, the positive square root of variance is called standard deviation. Thus, we can say the standard deviation is equals to under root of variance, or the variance is equals to SD square. In this slide I have discussed the one basic example along with the table and the graph. So to discuss what is actually the standard deviation and how it works, what is the variance and how it is different than the mean standard deviation and the variance. So in this slide, let's see the question. Following table shows the height of the different types of dogs. Find what is the normal and what is the extra large or the extra small heights of the dogs. So in the slide you can find the table in which there is a dog name and their height is given, and on the graph also you can find the different categories of the dogs. So they have measured the shoulder length of each and every dog, right? Let's say for example the standard average height of the Rottweiler category of dog is 600 mm, right? So in the graph you can find the shoulder length, and the arrow is, the red mark arrow is also given at the 600 measurement. So let's say first of all the size of the let's find the average height of all the dogs. So which is 600 mm plus 470 plus 170 plus 430 plus 300 mm, and which is divided by 5. So total 5 categories of dogs. So the mean average of this 5 category of dogs is 394, in which the highest size of the dog is 600 mm, and the lowest size is the 170 mm. In the next slide I have discussed to find the variance, we have to take each difference then square it, and then average the result. So that means the difference of each value compared to their average. So let's say the for the Rottweiler height is 600, so the average height of the all the dogs is 394. So 600 minus 394, so the outcome is 206. So the difference of the Rottweiler compared to their mean is 206, right? Same way for other categories of the dogs. And then you have to square the value and divide by number of category of the dogs, which is 5, right? So the variance is 21704, and in the next figure it shows the standard deviation. So the standard deviation is just the square root of the variance. So our variance is 21704. If we add the if we find the square root of this value, so the SD is 147. So this is the standard deviation. So in the figure also you can find in the second figure where the dogs images are available. So there is a green line which shows the average height of the all the dogs, so which is 394. So 147, which is the standard deviation. So you can see the range of the standard deviation from the positive and the negative side of the average, as well as the each and every dogs of the category of the dogs of the variance, right? So how far from the average height of the dog, right? So all three the values, all three notions you can find in this figure. So this is the actual difference of the mean, standard deviation and the variance. Let's see the coefficient of the standard deviation and the variance. So this both are the relative measures of the dispersion. So the coefficient of standard deviation is a relative measure of variance, which is calculated in order to compare the variability between two or more than two distributions. So the formula is coefficient of SD is equals to standard deviation divided by x bar, and the coefficient of variance is relative measures of dispersion. It expressed as the percentage and is useful to comparing the variability of two or more sets of data, especially if they are expressed in different unit of measurement. So the coefficient of variance is equals to standard deviation divided by x bar into 100. So always remember, the final answer of the coefficient of variance comes into the percentage. Let's see how to find the combined SD. Combined arithmetic mean can be computed if we know the mean and the number of items in each group of data. Same way, the combined SD can be computed if we know the x bar 1, x bar 2, standard deviation of 1, standard deviation of 2, n1 and n2. These values are required if we have the two set of groups, let's say the group 1 and the group 2. If we have a 3 set of groups, so we'll have x bar 3, standard deviation of 3, and the n3 value as well. Let's see the formula for the two set of groups. To find the combined standard deviation, so first of all we require to find the combined mean. So the combined mean formula is also available in the screen. So combine x bar the notation. If we have a two group, so we called it x bar 1 2. If we have a three group, so we called it x bar 1 2 3. So if we have a two group, so the formula is n1 into x bar 1 plus n2 into x bar 2 divided by n1 plus n2. And if we have a three group, so in the formula the third group terms is also added, you can find on the screen. And then after you have to find the combined standard deviation. So the notation of the combined standard deviation is standard deviation 1 and 2. If you have three groups, so instead of 1 2 you have to add three number, let's say 1 2 3. So that is equals to under root of n1 into the bracket standard deviation of 1 square plus d1 square close the bracket plus n2 into open the bracket standard deviation of 2 square plus d2 square close the bracket divide by n1 plus n2. So here the d1 is equals to the combined x bar minus x bar 1 and d2 is equals to combined x bar minus x bar 2. Empirical relationship among the QD, MD and SD. So the empirical relation between these two between these three measures are QD is equals to 5 by 6 MD which is equals to 2 by 3 SD, or you can say the 6 QD is equals to 5 MD is equals to 4 SD. Thank you for watching my video. We'll meet soon in the next session.